you, so. Okay, hi everybody, good afternoon. First things first, really, really sorry that you guys had to wait for so long. Sincere apologies from all of us. But then at the end,
sorry.
We're ladies.
I'd also like
and
to tell you that Yasmin is generally late for everything.
Oh!
But we do know, who walked in last.
My name's
Martin.
My
mother whose name is Yasmin.
So yes, welcome over here everyone. My name is Ramona Arena and I'm very happy to host this. As we all know, March is the month that actually celebrates women, and it's also the time when all of us want to start getting back into shape because summer's approaching. We're going to be on the beaches and in our swimwear and also in sleeveless things, and we just want to look good. And you know, I was also having a discussion with my friend the other day, and it's not just about looking good anymore. It's also about feeling good, and it's also about doing what you do in the best way that you can possibly do it. So what we've decided to do is meet up with these three fabulous women who, as you all know, are just the maestros when it comes to talking about fitness, health, and nutrition in this country. So please, a big round of applause for all three of them. Yasmin, Romina, and of course, Rachi. So, first things first, I'm just going to give you all a quick introduction, even though none of them need it. Yasmin Karachiwala, the pioneer of Pilates in India and the author of the book Sculpt and Shape, The Pilates Way. If you haven't bought it, buy it. You can get a copy outside.
And this wasn't about selling the book today.
No, it wasn't.
But you can still buy it.
Yes, yes. Yasmin is also the mega mind behind personal training and also of the personal training studio Body Image. And she is India's best known celebrity trainer. Woo! She is Sophie, and I don't know why she trains me, but I love that she does this.
Is
she
a celebrity?
Everyone, according to me, each person is a celebrity in their own right. So
even I am.
Some of them are on screen, and most of us are off screen, and we're all celebrities, especially
stars,
the women.
Not celebrities, stars in their own right. That's
celebrity stars.
Celebrity stars.
London se aayi hai, kya kare?
Okay, up next we have the lovely Romina Bhatia. Romina blends. So she blends two ingredients, innovation and creativity, with food and health, with a goal to guide people on how to incorporate healthy food habits. Using organic ingredients and healthy options for everyday lives, Romina's recipes and kitchen helps you to manage calories and still manage to have delicious food and fun in the kitchen. She's explored her passion for food, and she's taken a very bold step to create fat-free almost, firmly believing that you do not need to deprive yourself in order to stay fit and look fabulous. Romina! And of course, to our left, we've got Rashi Chaudhary. Now, Rashi is based in Dubai, and she is a nutritionist, a fat loss expert, a diabetic educator, and she hates weighing scales, diets, and fake food.
Ooh, don't we all?
I hate weighing scales.
You can't choose one. You left that one description.
You can't choose one. You have to have all three.
On her diet, you don't need
fake food
scales.
Is oh on God. That list of I hate.
Depends on your definition of food.
No, I'm just saying, so, yeah. She's an expert nutritionist. She's also a dictator.
Oh.
Yeah. Like, I don't really want to say this. He's not like my favorite person. But like, seriously.
As long as it works.
It works, but she's scary. But it works.
It looks scary. Do I look scary at all?
No, she looks unbelievably stunning, which is why everybody wants to do what she's doing. Yeah.
So she also loves to CrossFit, and she's the founder of the UAE's first and only green-free bakery. She's also been voted in the top 5 women changing the face of the fitness industry in the United Arab Emirates. Yeah, Rashi Chaudhary.
Thank you.
And then, should I introduce you? Do you want to introduce yourself?
No.
The lady needs no introduction. She looks gorgeous as always.
I'd also like to say that Ramona and I were both part of the initial MTV VJ hunt, and she was my first roommate ever in my life. So we go back. So yeah, it's lovely to be here. I don't think I need an introduction. It's really about these three amazing women and the fabulous stuff that they do to improve your lifestyle, your health, and generally your all over well-being. So I'm just happy to be here, but it's really about that.
Thank you.
Yeah, so is everyone ready to get fit with these fabulous three?
Yeah.
Okay, first question. What advice would you give to all those considering a healthier lifestyle? Yes, why don't you begin?
I would just say, first of all, you have to really understand and define for yourself what is healthy for you. Because most people say healthy, but they want to eat the chips once in a while, and they want to not work out, and they're too busy, and they have phone calls coming in when they need to do the treadmill. And so really, the first thing I would say is commitment. Okay, you need to be committed to yourself, and you need to want to be fit, because only then can we take it to the next step, which is then, you know, figure out what kind of exercise you need, what your food should be, and everything else. But guys, seriously, everyone, if you want to be fit, make a commitment to yourself to follow through the goals that you set for yourself as individuals, and not because Deepika Padukone does this or Katrina Kaif or Sophie Chowdhury, you know, goes to the gym 6 days a week and begs me to come on Sunday as well. But because her body and yours and anybody's body, even the person sitting next to you and your body is very different. Your needs are very different. Your goals definitely are different. You know, some people like Ramona want to wear a bikini in the summer, and some of us are just happy looking good. So it's all about setting your goals and following through.
Thanks. Do you want to answer that?
Yeah, actually I'd love to. And
So there are three things I want to really mention here, all right? To begin with, I really think that a healthier lifestyle starts with a healthier mindset. Now, any of you right now, if you're on a low-fat, low-cal diet because your friend's wedding is approaching, then that diet is going to fail. It's bound to fail, and that's not a healthier mindset. Is it? So I really think that, you know, you got to eat better because you want to live better, because you want to look great, and obviously, like how you said, you want to feel better, you know. If you eat better because of those reasons, then weight loss and getting the body you want is going to be a side effect. So change your perception, and the body is always going to follow. The second thing I always mention is the damn weighing scale. Like, what is it? We need, if there's one thing you can take away from me, you know, during this session, go home, throw away that weighing scale, because it means nothing, all right? What you should bother about is what your weight is made up of, all right? So if you have enough muscle, you have less fat, you're good. But the point is that the weighing scale needs to go away. You need to go by how many inches you're losing, which is something you promote as well. It has to be about inch loss. It's got to be about gaining muscle and dropping the fat, all right?
And now we have, sorry to button, but now we have lots of machines that tell you your body composition,
exactly.
Fat, muscle, and most of us look at it and the figures seem unbelievable, but trust me, they work.
Exactly. When you're trying to eat better, the point is that you want to gain muscle mass and you want to drop the fat. When that happens, the weight might go up, but you will look smaller. So it's got to be about the inches. And lastly, like again, what you said, you need to understand your body, you know, tune into what you really need, because maybe your friend is eating every 2 hours and dropping weight, but that may not be true for you. Maybe your friend eats breakfast and that's a good strategy for her, but maybe your body type is such that you don't need breakfast. So you have to tune into your own body and understand your body rather than just following what someone else is doing, you know. So yeah.
Very true that. In fact, just to put my two bits in, everyone looks at me and says like, oh, you're so fit, you're so fine. And I know that I'm actually not fit. And even Yasmin, she was like, oh, come on, it shouldn't be so bad as far as you're concerned. And she put me on the scale. She got the report and she just went, 2 hours every day.
You're not killing your entire
thin fat.
My
But like that just, but you know what, that just proves that a lot of people think that if you're skinny, you're obviously fit. And if you're skinny, you don't have any fat. And you'll be shocked to know that some really skinny people have a lot more fat than somebody who weighs much more. So I think that's the confusion that needs to go. There's a huge difference between fat and muscle. And so the chances are that you're probably a lot fitter than someone who's half your size. And you don't even know it. So that's, I think, something that needs to be promoted and explained like very clearly.
Absolutely. And would you like to answer that question as well?
They've answered really well. But what I'd like to say is that the best thing to do is have fun when you're making your food, because that's the key. Because what you put into your body is what's going to give you the results. So you need to play with your food, have fun. And if your nutritionist has asked you to have carbs, then you can try different carbs. You can try a different carb every day. You don't have to say, oh God, what am I going to do? What do I have to eat rice every day or a roti every day? But you have a quinoa, you have buckwheat flour, you have brown rice. You have so many varieties that you can play with. And also to be very prepared for your food, where you just have like a batch of hummus or, you know, different flavored hummus ready in your fridge. So if you're an office going person or you're busy, you know, it's stuck in your fridge. You just have to open it, fill it up in your lunchbox, and off you go, and you're all set for the day. And also to have accessible ingredients in your fridge, because if your fridge is filled with stuff which is junk, you're going to eat that stuff. But if you fill it up with fresh veggies and really, really healthy ingredients, you're not going to go wrong anyway. So that's just the way I can suggest that you have a healthier lifestyle by stacking good food at home.
Rovi, I've been opening my fridge every day for the last 1 month, and I just can't find that hummus. Seriously, which comes to me after every weekend. I have this whole variety of different hummuses, and I open my fridge and I can never find it. Do you think like the fridge is eating it up?
You just have to get in touch with Patrio or Lord, and we will give you all the flavors possible.
Just a supple, very supple.
So yeah, like she says, you have to enjoy cooking. Let me tell you that I hate cooking or anything to do, but I enjoy watching her and her recipes and the passion. We do salads, which we have at the gym, and the passion with which she talks to me about the ingredients she's going to put. I'm like, is it just gonna taste good, like, you know, at the end of it? But her passion for food and looking at food and the colors, and is amazing. It's amazing.
You can get
it's just that I can't find my hummus since 1 month.
All right. Well, just quickly to say thank you to our sponsors, Coco Fly, Almond Fresh, and Twinings, for the wonderful little treats that all of you have had in your goodie bags. We're now going to have these three, fabulous three, share and tell us about how these products help keeping them fit. So, Yasmin?
Tea. I'm going to talk about the tea because I am a big coffee drinker. And post 4 o'clock, I try not to put any more coffee in my body, and then I turn to tea. And what better tea than Twining? And what I really like about Twining is that they have different flavors, and I'm not a tea drinker. So for me, when you flavor it with a little bit of lemon or a little bit of, you know, peppermint, it just feels refreshing, because actually you just need something warm to go down, which suits you instead of, you know, makes you hyper. And it has antioxidants and a lot of nutritional, you know, benefits. It makes you look good. Does it make you lose weight? Okay, people who drink green tea don't lose weight. Otherwise, we'd all be in the Himalayas. So, yeah, for people who drink green tea thinking they're going to lose weight with it.
You have to do other things also.
No, even if you do other things, the tea's not making it. It detoxifies you, it has antioxidants, you know, it's really good for you. It has no caffeine, and overall it's really good. And if you guys haven't tried it, please try it. It's in your goodie bag.
Yeah. Rowena?
Well, I'm going to talk about Almond Fresh, which is my favorite. It is an absolutely amazing thing that we now have almond milk in our city, in our country. You can make anything with it, maybe your smoothies, your even there are cookie recipes that we have on Factory Almost where you can use almond milk if you're lactose intolerant. It is the absolute amazing thing to do. I've even tried making yogurt out of almond milk and it is absolutely delicious. It almost has a little vanilla kind of flavor. Like
some
she says, yes. unfortunately, there's nothing for you to try today, but it's a lovely substitute for regular milk where a lot of people find it difficult to digest regular milk. It's too heavy. And Almond Fresh is just smooth and creamy and the texture is nice. So you can create so many yummy things with it. And I think it's great that it's available to us right now here. So it's fantastic.
Super, and Rashi?
Okay, so I'm a big promoter of real food. So every time I pick up a packaged product, I'm very skeptical about it. But Cocoa Fly, if you look at it, and this is true with any packaged product, pick it up. If the nutrition label looks too difficult to read and it's something that you don't want to, you know, bother with, just look at the ingredients. Okay, the lesser the ingredients, the better. And it's always in the order of predominance. So the ingredient that's the most in it will always be initially written. Now, if you pick up Cocoa Fly, you see it has just one ingredient. And the only one it's got is 100% pure coconut water. So I love having it. It hydrates me. The pH of coconut water is very close to our blood. So what happens is that it instantly hydrates you. Yeah, so that's, I mean, I love Cocoa Fly because of all of these reasons. And it's super convenient, so you guys can definitely.
Yeah, and Rashi lives in Dubai, and I follow her food plan. And every time she'd be like, just have the coconut water, just have almond milk. And then she'd post these pictures of these amazing packaging. And she says, these are like almost 100%. I'm like, we don't get them here.
Yeah,
so if you want me to have it, send it. So now I don't need
to be
pregnant.
Coconut water is perfect.
Okay, Rashi. I just want to ask you, what are the three most common myths around dieting?
Oh my God, yes, please. Thank you for asking. Okay, so you said three, yeah. So the first one here would... I'll stick to three, don't worry. Okay, the first one is, which I hear from a lot of you guys, is that fat makes you fat. Now, I want you to understand this concept really, really well, that eating fat does not make you fat. Sometimes when I sit with my clients one-on-one, I actually increase their consumption to triple.
Yay.
I swear to God. And this is not
a true. I did recently. I had pasteurized butter. And
yeah.
I know what happened.
And she had
it
on
fat. You actually dropped fat.
No, no, ask her what she had the pasteurized butter on.
What was it on?
Bread.
Yeah. So that's a recipe for disaster, okay? But hear me out. So listen, most of the hormones in our body, 80% of them are made from fat. This is not my opinion, it's just science. So if you want to be hormonally healthy, you have to increase the amount of fat you actually consume. Alright, so that's number one. Start adding ghee, butter, coconut oil, but don't do what she did. If you're going to take bread,
and you're going to have it
as a perfect example.
I mentioned that, you know, because if you're going to have butter on top of bread, then that's not the best combination.
In 3 days.
Based on?
3 days of that.
That's not bad. 3 days is nothing. But anyway, the point is that, so please start adding the good fats in your diet. Cut out the bad fat, all right? That's number one. Second thing, okay, which oil do you guys use at home for cooking? What do you guys use?
Sunflower.
Okay, if you're using a vegetable oil, please know it's cheap. It's refined, it's not giving you anything. Lastly, it has way too much omega-6. Now, this might be a little complicated, but what I want you to understand is that your body needs a very good ratio or a very delicate ratio of omega-3 to omega-6. We are getting way too much omega-6 than we need from the cooking oil because we eat outside. Outside, no one's going to cook your food in, you know, in coconut oil. It's going to be in regular cheap oil. So we're getting too much omega-6, which is why most women nowadays have PCOD, or a lot of people have thyroid. All these are inflammation disorders, all right? So start cooking in ghee, butter, coconut oil, mustard oil. These are your best bets. And lastly, I'd say, yeah, fruit juices. Whether they are fresh or they are packaged, I'm sorry, but take it from a diabetic expert, diabetic educator. It is nothing but liquid candy, all right? The effect that a glass of even fresh orange juice has on your blood sugar levels is as good as having 3 tablespoons of chini. It's the same thing. You can't eat 4 oranges at one time, but you can drink them easily. Alright, so it's no good. Fruit juice is something, you don't need to juice your fruits, just eat them how they're supposed to be eaten.
If you are asked.
I think it depends on your fitness level.
Yeah. And your activity. And I think our MC is learning the most today.
Yeah. See your face. And all of you on our faces, please look at the expression every time one of us says something. You're like,
that's why she stood on the scale and the fat percentage was so high, because she's a cheater.
I am. I love sugar and I love everything fried. So I'm a nightmare for all three of you.
Check your lipid profile as well. Just throwing it there.
Okay, let's stop talking about me. Let's attack you now, Rowena. Okay, so people on diets often feel like they've been sent on a prison sentence. I say yes. So give us some tips on how to make food fun and not just something that's bland, boring, or, you know, oh, I can only eat this much. And...
Okay, first thing I'd like to say is when anyone is sitting and says, okay, you have to go on a diet. I think the first thing one thinks of is, oh my god, I have to have boring steamed vegetables and salads which are full of leaves. So that's your misconception here, because even a simple thing like a salad, you can make it so delicious. You got to add your protein to it, which your nutritionist will tell you that you need to have protein. So you add some chickpeas, some red kidney beans or some pearl barley, and you spruce it up and you make your salad absolutely delicious. So you want to eat it, you look forward to that salad. You don't say, oh my god, I'm just going to open a bowl of leaves and I don't want to eat this. But you're going to have so many options to play with. And secondly, the ingredients that you use, let's say you have fussy kids, you know, and you really want to feed them and you want to give them fiber and nutrition. And let's take a simple thing that you would see in our recipe book here. We have a recipe for a brownie. And if you give a child a piece of brownie, he's going to eat it without even thinking twice. But the brownie here is made completely out of sweet potato. It has nothing wrong, and it's a gluten-free brownie. It has dates and agave nectar or honey for sweetening and a little bit of raw cocoa. And it is so delicious, but the child doesn't know what's in it. Or you, even a fussy eater, wouldn't know what's in it, but you eat it and it's so delicious. And what you've done is given your body the absolute nutrition that you need without eating any refined sugar and still taking care of your sweet tooth. And you know, you've made food fun for yourself. So that's the idea. That's how I would say, don't make it sound like it's a sentence for you, but it's absolutely a fun thing to try out and make it your lifestyle. Don't call it a diet. It's like your lifestyle. You just do this on a regular basis. You just choose the right ingredients. You know, don't even know what's the wrong stuff anymore, because you always stack the right stuff at home.
So I actually tried the brownie that she's talking about, the sweet potato brownie. Oh my god. It was really, really good, and you couldn't tell. You just couldn't tell.
Alright, so I'm looking forward to trying that. I could change.
You can open your fridge every day and look for it.
So how many brownies can one have in
here? If it's sweet potato and dates and all of the stuff that she's saying, then you can have like 4 as a quick snack.
Wow.
How big are they? So I know what the brownie looks like, right? I know it in my mind.
So the brownie is like a chicken.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes. We're thinking brownie.
Like, yeah, a nice cup of brownie.
So my bad, because I had it yesterday, so I know exactly what they look like. Oh, but the recipe is in the book.
Yeah,
so,
there's a recipe.
There's a book.
Yeah.
And then we can. Come on, wow. You have to make it for us.
Our chef.
Rowena's still making my hummus.
But have it as a snack, okay? The worst thing you can do is have it as a dessert after your full meal. Don't do that.
Just something that we made 4 snacks a day.
I mean, 1 snack.
Four of the pieces that she gave me yesterday.
She's gonna
make
her
life with a candle.
It's okay, I'm ready to.
She deserves it because she's fit. Be fit because you deserve it. Get hell because you deserve it.
Okay, yeah, so now I'm gonna come to you.
Yeah, finally.
Yes. So there's a lot of people that struggle to find time to work out. Life is very hectic. And yeah. So I know that my shoes have been in your gym since October, which is when I had my last workout. I'm coming tomorrow.
I follow you on Twitter and Instagram and all the social media and know exactly what you're up to. When you say you don't have time, so I'm quite a stalker
Stop it!
I was traveling and I went to these places.
But I was.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So that is something everyone says, I don't have time to work out. And like I started earlier, is the commitment. If you've made the commitment and you want to be true to it, you will make time to work out. And honestly, if you don't have time for a full 1 hour workout, break it up. You see, all of us, we wear something called the jawbone. We're not advertising for it, but we all wear it, and even auntie's wearing it. And it just counts your step. So you make a target of, say, 5,000, 6,000 steps a day. So whatever else you do, you make sure you complete your steps. All your phones now are smartphones, I'm sure, because all of you sitting here look pretty smart to me. It has different apps to count your steps. There's a Nike Plus app. There's different things. Monitor the amount of steps you do. You can break your 1 hour of workout that you need in a day to 5 minutes, 10 times a day. You know, it can just be five very quick things that you do, maybe five times a day. And you don't need to find that 1 hour. You know, so when you don't have time, plus, all of us have mobiles. I'm sure all of you have mobiles here. Raise your hands, all those who don't have mobiles. So when I'm having a 1 hour gossip session with my best friend about how that girl that I went to the party really irritated me because she was eyeing my husband. She was so damn good looking and hot that he was paying me no attention. Vicious. And looking. Walking while you're talking. Just walk around the room while you talk on the phone. Why do you have to be glued to a chair when the three of us are standing and moving and burning some calories, you know? So men, women, humans come from the animal world. We're animals. And animals are meant to move. Our lives have become so sedentary that we get down in the lift, our car is waiting at the porch, we don't even want to walk to the car because we've told the driver the night before, jab main niche aungi, meri gaadi udhar chahiye. So we've called the driver when we're getting into the lift and said, main niche aa rahi hu, gaadi taiyar rakho. You know, we want a glass of water, we call, Ramu, pani lao. Okay, we don't do any work, we don't move. Of course, it's too hot in Bombay to park your car far away and walk to the car, or if you're living on the 30th floor, to walk up the stairs. But you can get off on the 25th floor and walk up five stories of stairs, you know, to make sure you get some movement in the day. My best thing is walking when I'm talking. Not right now, but normally. Because you burn calories, you're moving, you know, you have so many expressions because you're just, and he was looking at her, I don't know. So your arms are moving, you know, you're getting a full body movement, not workout, because to work it out, you would have to have some weight bearing. But you can even, while talking, put it on speaker, go to your table, do some table push-ups, sit on your chair, do some tricep dips. There are lots of exercises you can do while talking on the phone. So, you know, that's what I'd say, there's never not enough time to move.
Amount of time that you think one should devote in a week, let's say.
To be healthy?
Yeah, to be healthy and fit.
At least 30 minutes a day to be healthy. Okay. To be fit depends on what your fitness, your current fitness level is. And again, one rule does not work for everyone. So I would just say to be healthy, to have good digestion, to, you know, not have problems. 30 minutes a day is the minimum you should be doing. If you want to be fit, if you want to look like Sophie Chowdhury or Deepika Padukone, I don't mean look exactly, but be as slim as them, then it depends where you are right now and what you have to do to get there.
Alright, thank you. And Sophie, you've got a very, very hectic schedule, I know. But then I also stalk you on social media. And you are constantly working out. How do you find the time to balance those two? And how do you look like you do?
Thank you. I think some of you guys can't see me, so I'll stand. You know, actually, I just think that the most important thing is to change your lifestyle and make it a lifestyle. So I don't look at working out like a chore. If I don't do a session of Pilates or if I don't do any movement in the day, I'm miserable. And it's not because I want to be thin and I want to fit into that super tight Hervé Léger dress or anything like that. It's I, within myself, don't feel good. I don't feel positive if I do not work out or do not do some form of exercise. When it comes to food, perhaps I'm fortunate that I generally enjoy healthy food, but again, I don't think of it as a diet. In fact, when I met Rashi, the first thing I said to her is, I've never done a diet in my life, and it's true. I do not diet. I do not deprive myself of anything, but I maintain a basic healthy lifestyle. I think we all know what's good for us and what's not good for us. It's logic. I don't think you really need somebody to tell you that. You just need to be able to have the strength from within to just take that on. The one thing that I did do when I went to Rashi, I know I drove you crazy, because I didn't really follow too much of what she said, but there is, who reduced the volume? No. You can keep it up. I know how to control a mic, thank you. So I think the one thing that I did take away from Rashi, which has changed my life, is I'm somebody who likes desserts. I'm somebody who likes sugar, which I know is hard to believe, but give me anything from a tiramisu to a rasmalai and I will have it. But what I have stopped doing is, the minute I met her, I stopped adding any sugar to any tea or coffee. And I know that all of us have at least one or two teas in a day, or three or four. If you're in Bombay, it's cutting chai, it's this big, so you end up having four or five. Just stop adding sugar and you'll see a huge difference. And another thing that happened is I became gluten-free. And that is a huge change in your life. Now for people who say things like, I need my roti, believe it or not, in Bombay you can get gluten-free atta. And we make rotis from that at home now. I generally don't eat Indian food maybe more than once or twice a week. And I know that sounds crazy, but the amount of great food you can have without having all your desi masale and cooked in oil and tons of roti and tons of chawal, it's amazing if you get out there and you explore. The thing is, I don't have to because I have this incredible mother who goes on the internet every single day and finds a new recipe, be it from Jamie Oliver or whoever, to come up with an exciting, interesting salad. You know, things like grilling a sweet potato. There's so many exciting things you can do, which is what Rowena was talking about, which is what Rashi says, which is what Yaz says. But the most important thing is to not be healthy and crazy healthy for 1 week and then give it up. That's what everybody does. I'm going to get fit this week. I'm going to work out every day. I'm going to eat salads all week. And then you give up. And that's the saddest thing. I think it's better if you're slow and steady and change your lifestyle so that it is your life. Rather than saying, I'm going to get fit next month, so I'll do this for 2 weeks. And then stop, because that's pointless. That's just not going to achieve you any results. I think the only reason that I kind of am like this is because I'm consistent. I don't diet. I don't work out like crazy 1 week. I am just like this. So I think I pretty much look the same because I'm always like this. And I think that's just the best advice I can give anyone, is to not be extreme. Don't starve yourself. Don't deprive yourself. Just try and adopt an overall healthier lifestyle, and trust me, you will be a happier person. More than being thin and more than, you know, getting into your favorite pair of tight jeans, which is great, it feels great, you will be a much happier person when you eliminate all of those negative things that you're eating, all of those excuses that I don't have time for myself. That's just not true. If it means getting up half an hour earlier, you have to do it. If it means sleeping half an hour later, you have to do it. You have to make time for yourself. And the biggest example I can give of this, and she is by far, Yaz, the most popular client of yours at Yasmin's Body Image. And that is my mom, who used to be, I think, my size right until her 50s. Then, having lived in England for 47 years of her life, and that's where I'm born and brought up, I made her move here because of this crazy dream that I wanted to pursue. Now, when you're in England, you have a very active lifestyle. My mom was doing Pilates 25 years ago with the man who brought Pilates to England. So I was aware of it as a kid. And then you come to Bombay and the same thing, Ramu, Pani Lao, Gadi Lao, Ye Lao, where is there to walk? I think the first, when we moved here, my mom actually broke her leg because she's not used to looking down when she's walking. And everything has a pothole. What are you supposed to do? So after all of these years, we've been here 10 years now, just over 10 years, it's been 11, 12 years actually now. And I finally convinced my mom to join Yaz. And mom started going to Yaz regularly in end of April. And she lost 16 kilos by October. So the reason I'm saying this is because anybody who says, I'm getting older, it's so much harder. Anyone who says, I do not have the time. It's, you know what, if you want to do it, you will do it. And let me tell you, when she's in the gym, everybody who's half her age is feeling motivated and embarrassed because they're like, oh my God, like she's doing this, we need to do this. So I'm just saying that it's a strength and a desire that comes from within, and if you want it, you will do it.
Thank you very much.
And she's a very tough cookie to please, Auntie, because she's done Pilates with the person who brought Pilates to London, straight from Joseph Pilates, and when she's in the gym, actually, Sophia and I are little at attention so that we don't make any mistakes. And her dedication and, you know, just overcoming all her different problems, and there's not a day that, you know, she, and she says that, oh, I'm not feeling well, because she said, you know, today I'll do it a little lightly because I'm not feeling up to it. But she's there. And she's not just a mother who's sitting at home and, you know, looking for recipes for Sophie and cooking for her. She is her manager. So she does all of managing Sophie and all the other things and makes time for herself to come and work out. And I think she deserves a round of applause.
Yay! Okay, so everybody stood up, and I think I should do now.
Finally! Woohoo! You're an animal now.
This is the coolest gig I've ever gotten to host. Because the gig, you know, usually has the host standing, the guest sitting down, the speaker sitting down, and the role was reversed, and this is after...
Like, because what? It's a fitness.
It's amazing!
And you can only be fit if you deserve it.
Yes. So I'm going to keep walking because I deserve it. And now I'm going to ask you guys, do you all have any questions for our experts over here? Any questions?
I have a question.
Yeah.
You just said that you shouldn't have the butter with the bread. And what do you have?
So, well, like I said, it depends a lot on where you are currently at your fitness level, what you're trying to get at. Which is why when she talks about commitment and all of that, there needs to be some goal you're trying to reach at. So it depends. Why don't you tell me what your goal is right now?
Just to where I am.
Then one of the changes you will make is just start cooking your food in ghee, coconut oil or butter. If you were someone who was struggling with weight and you were just stuck with stubborn weight and just not losing it, then I would recommend wake up in the morning, have a tablespoon of ghee or butter and start your day like that. But since that's not one of your goals, just make sure you start cooking in better, you know, medium or fat.
So if I have to have butter in the morning.
If you have to have...
You don't have to. Yeah, but if I want to, I want to.
Okay, so I'll tell you. So generally, this whole butter concept comes...
What butter was?
If you can't do pasteurized, unsalted butter, ideally I do pasteurized,
unsalted.
You have unsalted. Yeah, so then what you can do... Again, this is not... Like I said...
And I used to not have it before. But it's just because I go to Yaz so regularly. I've been there for the last 13 years.
Right.
So now it's every time all the tips come up, so you start with, okay, a little bit fat in the morning.
Right. So let me put this.
It's yours only.
Yeah, fat in the morning works beautifully for people, one who are just not losing weight. If there are some who are metabolically deranged, what that means is you have thyroid, you have PCOD, you have endometriosis, you know, you're diabetic. And you had extra weight to lose, and no matter what you do, have you had clients like this? No matter what they do, no matter what workout they do, they just don't drop weight. That is because you are metabolically deranged. So what you will do for 2 weeks, you got to go completely on a different tangent. What I do with my clients is they wake up and they have a tablespoon of butter blended in black coffee. Now this sounds insane, but it works like, I know. Face that you're making right now. Okay, if you blend it, then it tastes
like cappuccino.
But a fake cappuccino, because obviously there's no lactose in it. Butter does have lactose, very little. So when you blend it like that and have it, after a couple of days, you will want it. Simple. Because your brain starts functioning better, you have lesser cravings, you're going to be fuller for longer. Having said that, a lot of people, not a lot, say 20% of my clients don't respond well to it. So then we change it. Then they do a tablespoon of ghee in the morning. But like I said, it depends on where you are at your current fitness level and what you're aiming towards. So yeah.
So how does one determine your current fitness level?
Okay, one, are you happy when you wake up every morning? Are you happy with the body you have? If you don't have it, then it's time to make a change, because if you're not feeling good about yourself, what is the point? That's one. Second thing, when you're climbing steps, are you able to climb them, you know, normally? Otherwise, generally I tell people, do a 5K. See how long it takes you. If it's going to take you more than 10 minutes to do 1 kilometer, then you're just in really bad, like you're really in a bad
No, I'd say 12 minutes.
12?
10
really?
Is for a fit person, yeah.
So for 5K you, or
1K?
For
1K. 12. Do a 5K doing 10, 1 kilometer for 10 minutes, in 10 minutes, which I think is average, but you have to give a leeway to people
so, yeah,
who have some, you know.
No, that's your forte. So obviously, that's how we judge. But to me, I want to wake up every morning and feel good about my body. You know, I want to feel good. I want to feel like I'm looking good and feeling good and all of that. If you're not feeling like that, then it's time to change.
So what if you're looking really good?
And
you're
feeling good.
You're feeling wonderful. You're looking good. But when you climb up the steps, you're breathless.
Yeah, so then clearly that it's time to change. Then you're not fit. So then it's time to change, exactly.
What if I'm looking good and I'm feeling good, but I don't want to get up. I want to sleep some
more.
That's all yes.
That won't happen.
I never want to wake up in the morning.
I don't believe that, yes.
She gets enough people that. Like that.
Any more questions? Yes.
What's a good substitute for butter? A person stubborn fat, aging.
If you can't
you have all the problems that age related problems.
Yeah.
But still you want to have butter on bread.
Is this for you?
Yeah.
Okay. So you should probably do ghee. Do a tablespoon of ghee in the morning. If not, just do a tablespoon of coconut oil. Do you have issues with your digestion and stuff? Not at all. You're not bloated?
Well, I think I've got
if you're bloated, then you need a
fat.
Yeah, but then stubborn fat is just it's not the... right. No, I think you should start with a tablespoon of coconut oil.
On bread?
No. If you're going to mix your
bread.
Carbs, if you're
you
going
to
mix...
You have to give up bread.
Exactly. Not everyone needs to give up bread.
Initially.
Not everyone, initially. But it depends. If you're saying you have stubborn fat, then you need to make drastic changes to shock your body a bit.
Try
gluten-free bread.
That'll help you.
Where do you get... Anywhere.
Nature's Basket.
Nature's Basket has it freely available.
Just have bajra roti
yeah.
and jawar roti.
Substitute your wheat. Delete your wheat from... You should be wheat.
Yeah.
If you're a bread lover, trust me, you won't like gluten-free bread. It's kadak.
Two
so just
yeah,
stick to
a bread lover.
You can. What
so
I do is I piece so brown rice. Now you get brown
oh.
rice atta, and I make rotis out of brown rice. So
yeah,
that really works.
Yeah.
Brown rice and it's
maybe your stubborn fat is because you're very stubborn about liking bread.
Yeah.
You should change your mindset.
I think you've eaten bread for enough years of your life. It's time to make a change. You have to either give up the fat or the
bread. What
bread
do you have?
Make your choices like I said initially.
Well, I buy varieties of bread.
Any other questions?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll come back to you guys.
Spondylitis, and I had like really bad issues, I had and everything. So. But now I have like belly fat, which I can't do crunches. I can't do crunches or anything anymore.
Okay, so her question is, wow, this is really good. After talk softly. So her question is, she underwent a surgery. She has some cervical spondylosis problem. And because of that, she's developed belly fat. I think we need to review what you're eating, what your activity is. Because seriously, if you do crunches till the cows come home only, you're not going to lose that belly fat. Belly fat has nothing to do with doing abdominal exercises. It's lifestyle, it's what you eat, it's what your fitness level is. It's a combination of fitness, food, and nutrition. So a consult with all three of us would be a good idea. I'm totally selling it right now.
A lot of people go to gyms or trainers saying, I need to lose weight only from my hips, or I need to lose weight only from my arms, or it's basically people believe in spot reduction. But I think, you know, there's a lot of people who come, I mean, I've done this with Yaz, I want to lose weight, but I don't want to lose weight on my face. Yeah, that's just unrealistic. It's just not going to happen. And if anybody thinks that only by doing hip exercises you'll get better hips, or if only by doing arms you'll get better arms, it doesn't happen. It has to start with your food. And I really believe that how you look is at least, I mean, the workout is usually important, but 70% is what you put in. Right? Sorry, yes, I know that working out is hugely important.
I totally believe in that as well. And like she said, I have people who say, I want to lose weight, but I don't want my face to go because the charm goes. I have some Sindhi women who come and they say, I want to lose weight, and they're doing beautifully till one auntie who has come met them and said, itni weak ho gayi hai. Then the next time they come to class, they put on 5 kilos and say, yes, I've put on 5 kilos. The person laughing the loudest is the one with that example. But Parul, really what, it's a combination of the three. So maybe you're working out and, you know, you're doing everything else. And if you actually review what you're eating and what kind of workouts you're doing, you'll find the answer yourself because you're smart.
But then when you meet people, sabse pehle ye kahenge, bade cool down lag rahe hain aap. Instead of saying you're looking good.
आपको कोई आपको पता नहीं है पुल डाउन क्या है यार पुल अप आप अपने आप को पुल अप करो चीकी आंसर टू समवन लाइक दैट सो दे वोंट से दैट अगेन टू यू एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर हैप्पी विद द वे यू लुक और आई गेट पीपल हु से आई एम फाइन बट आई जस्ट वांट टू लूज वेट ऑन माय फेस व्हेन आई टेक पिक्चर्स माय फेस लुक्स वेरी चबी So I send them to my friend who's a makeup artist, and I say, learn how to contour.
All right, the girls in the back.
What's with the no carbs after sunset? Like, how do you live like that? How do you live without carbs after sunset?
So, well, everyone does not need to not eat carbs after sunset. But if you're training in the evening, if you're working out in the evening, then definitely push in some carbs in the evening. But not for everyone, you know. What is it that you're looking for?
The thing is, if I have a light meal, like it's not carbohydrate, like then the morning
you
I
understand fruits and vegetables have carbohydrates.
Yeah,
well.
Exactly,
that.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's
okay.
The only thing I end up having, like fruits and vegetables at night. Then I drop weight in the morning, and
but
it's
you're
just
still
something.
Having your carb because you are
exactly
eating.
Exactly. So you can't have roti, sabzi like later on in the.
No,
day.
But you cannot eat fruit and vegetable for dinner. You cannot do
no,
that.
Like,
you will not lose weight.
Yeah, okay. That's the thing. I'm not losing weight with that.
But you just said you wake up in the morning and your scale is...
Yeah, it's
so
a little
one
bit.
First thing is you
throw
your scale.
Exactly.
You
that's
throw
what
the
I'm
damn
taking.
Scale.
Yes.
Second thing is, when you're eating, if you're eating to lose weight, alright, you've got to be smart with your macros. When I say macros, means your carb,
protein
fat.
Yeah.
These are your macros. What you've done is only eaten carbs at night. So forget about weight loss.
Okay.
I don't know your body completely, but what I would recommend generically is you do protein and fat at night.
Okay.
So you're better off having, I don't know, eggs with avocado, or let's say dal with sabzi.
Okay.
That also has carbs, but at least there's protein and fat in it as well. Or chicken and veggies, I don't know, depending. Are you vegetarian?
No, I just have chicken.
You have chicken, yeah? So chicken and vegetables is perfect.
Okay.
That's way better than having just
salad.
Fruit salad, yeah.
You had a question, yeah.
Every day we are bombarded with different kinds of fitness regime, diets and everything. So what to follow and what to not? Like you are telling a different, completely different thing as per the diet.
Right.
And when we go through internet or the television and when we go through newspapers, every day there's a new funda for diet, fitness and workouts, different kinds of workouts. So
see, it is very, very confusing. I agree. There are some people who say go by calories, some people say no, some people say cut your portions out. I think it's what's important is you understand your body, you know. Like, again, first fix a goal. What is your goal? You have to fix a goal,
yeah.
Alright? And this is how much I want to lose, and please not weight. It's got to be body fat percent. Alright? That's one. Now you have, for example, you go get your body fat percentage done and your muscle is very low. For most Indian women, okay, most of you, if you do your analysis, your muscle mass is going to be low, that's for sure. I don't know how you have 27 kgs of muscle on you. Obviously, how means you've obviously been training for so long, which is
now
why.
It's become 26 with my knee broken.
It's okay, you'll build it back up. Yeah, but if you have, if you're low on muscle but high on fat, which is pretty much a lot of us here, then you have to increase your protein. So you'll have to eat more dal, more chicken, more, you know, fish, more eggs, more all of that. So you have to know your, like I said, understand your body. Not everyone is going to be successful on a gluten-free plan. When you eat wheat, does it bloat you? Do you feel tired? Do you feel edgy? If you do, then cut it out for a week and see what you feel like. So understand your body, tune into it, you know.
Also, I know you're, it's confusing, but you know what, I think the best way to judge it is which one can you adopt permanently? You know, like, look at, there's so many things on the internet. If you look at it and you say, you know, this is not something that I can make my lifestyle, then clearly that diet is not for you. Because what you have to do is you have to follow a food plan that becomes your lifestyle so that you're doing it every day. Yes, when you want to lose a bit of extra weight, you have to push yourself a little bit further. But by and large, you have to eat what you can eat consistently every day. So if you're looking at things and you're just saying, there's no possible way I can do that, then that diet's not for you.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, the first time I ate sweet potato and avocado, I was like, oh my god, never. Now I'll die in a tub of avocado and I'll be fine. You know, so I think you have to make that, like, I understood that wheat does not work for me. So
no, but I'm saying in terms of forms of diets where there's certain that say limit yourself to this many calories in a day. If you cannot function doing that, you don't understand how to do that, that diet is not for you.
Exactly.
Or if there's something that tells you only do protein and nothing else,
exactly,
that's just not feasible. You have to, you know, follow something that's sensible. That's, I think that's the best advice to give you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's extreme. Do a diet of barley water or do a diet of, you know, pineapple
that's
juice. That's all ridiculous. None of that is ever going to work. You have to be sensible enough to look at a diet and say, this balances things out in a way that I can deal with, I think. And that's right?
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
I think the most important thing is not to Google so much on the internet. Okay, because internet is not Indian bodies only. And every country has a different set of food and a different set of body types and things like that. So it's much better to follow someone in your vicinity, in your area. Again, in India, there are so many states and every state has different kinds of food. So what, you know, like a diet that we follow in Bombay might not be a diet you follow in Indore or in Chandigarh. You know, the food available is different. So internet is great for a lot of things, but for something as personal as food and exercise, it's very individualistic and your body is your own. It's no one else's. What works for me will not work for you. You know, if I have 27 kgs of fat, muscle, she can't have that even if she starts lifting heavy weights because her body is made up differently. So understand your own body first, okay? Sophie said, find a diet that works for you. Don't find a diet that has everything that you like to eat, which might not be good for you. So be sensible, be smart. All of us have smartphones. I keep coming back to the smartphones, but it's a great example because everyone goes around saying, I'm so smart, or, you know, or in your mind you're thinking you're smarter than the next person, you know, the person next to you. Then why the hell are you not making, sorry for the language, smart choices in life? If you're smart, make smart workout and food choices for a smarter, healthier, better life.
Any more questions?
Yeah. My question is from Ms. Rubina. I am a great fan of your recipes, first of all.
Thank you.
I would like to understand, can you suggest some recipes that we could carry, a quick bite that we could carry to work and keep the energy going on?
Well, firstly, if you log on to website, you'll find a million recipes every day, new recipes coming up every day. But the best thing to do is have fun with your food, like I said before, and be prepared so you can make like hummus or avocado butter and keep it in your fridge stocked up. So if you just cut out a few vegetables, throw a dollop of that, carry a little bit of your brown rice. Every day you have a different lunchbox idea. You can whip up salads and, you know, things that make it interesting, and choose your
vegetables with color. Everything that has color is really, really good for you. You know, the darker the colors, the better it is. So you fill up your box with colorful veggies and you look at it and it looks so good when you open it in your lunch break and you know you had a horrible boss and he's yelling at you and you suddenly open up the box like, oh my god, and I have this yummy meal to go to. So you keep yourself prepared like that. And another thing that she said is about movement. When you're talking on the phone, you're moving around, you do it on the weekend. You go to a farmer's market, you look at these amazing vegetables available, you move your body to find your food on the weekends. The whole week is prepared for. You have your stuff ready, you know, stacked up. You know what you're going to cook. You're going to have fun with your entire, you know, health regime.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Is avocado fruit or vegetable?
It's fruit.
It's both. It's the butter good?
Of course, the avocado butter is the most delicious thing you can ever have.
Yeah, so has it got a lot of fat?
Good fat.
So avocados is one thing you have to include if you're struggling with stubborn weight or you have PCOD, any of those things. Because like I said, that's the kind of fat that makes the hormones inside your body. You want to be hormonally healthy all the time. Yeah, so you have to add avocado or butter or I don't know, nut butters.
I mean, she knows this better probably, but a Mars bar, a chocolate Mars bar, has the exact same amount of calories that you would find in an avocado, okay? But what you're eating in that avocado is like having that ghee or the coconut oil in the morning. You're giving your body the best that you can. You're going to glow, you're going to look good, you're going to lose that fat because you're eating that right thing. You're not eating that chocolate bar that's going to give you pimples and you're going to look horrible and you're going to put on weight. But with this avocado, you're going to lose weight, you're going to eat the right stuff, and yet you're eating the exact amount of calories that your dietitian is telling you to eat. So you're just right on track if you eat an avocado.
So it's a good substitute for butter.
It is, absolutely. It's a good substitute.
I want to put white rice.
Okay, white rice depends a lot on your digestive tract. So a lot of my clients who don't respond well to wheat, we do white rice. White rice actually is very alkaline. So if you're someone who's struggling with any inflammatory disorders, you must include white rice over gluten products. So like, get your chapati out, get your bread out, and replace it with white rice. Even my diabetic clients, I'll give them white rice, but then I'll make them put a tablespoon of ghee on it. Because that way their sugar level won't shoot up. Otherwise white rice will always shoot your sugar level up. So you always add some good fat in it.
Like Indian diet has rice, roti, dal.
Huh.
So then you have to cut out
of
your roti and just eat the rice?
You're not going to have rice and roti together. I'm sorry. That's just not allowed.
That's
all right.
Oh my gosh.
You can
eat
rice. No.
My
dad
is the biggest problem with the Indian
diet. See, their digestive
in
process.
Indian diet, because yes, everybody has roti as well as rice.
Which is all of us. Yeah.
Together.
Yeah. But that's not, it doesn't make, scientifically it doesn't make sense. Also, see, you've got to do these things by yourself, right? You've got to try and eliminate it, see how
it
you
makes
feel.
Sense. Scientifically, it may not.
Agreed.
And like I said, you have to make your choice. Is your choice to eat roti, rice, dal, or is your choice to lose weight and get fitter? If your choice is to eat it and, you know, whatever, then that's your choice.
Can I actually have a question?
Because we're in India, and like we were saying, even on the internet, it doesn't address a lot of Indian issues. So from both of you, because you're talking about food and nutrition, three food items, each of you, that Indians must absolutely eliminate from their diet. Like three food items that they... Yeah, they must eliminate. Because the three... No, yeah, as opposed to add, but they must absolutely eliminate because they always go to things that they just should completely avoid.
Sugar and sugar.
Different ones in the city, and then they make their own diet. And that is a diet. Because if Rashi Chowdhury said butter was good, and Robina said avocado was good, and Pooja Makhija said glucose biscuits were good, and somebody else said bread was good, and so you're going to take all the good that everyone said, and voila, you're your own nutritionist who's put all the, you know, and that's not going to work. So, you know, that in my books is the worst thing to do, is to go to different nutritionists, take what each one is saying and be your own nutritionist and take all the foods you like.
What about multivitamins? Probably.
multivitamins are a complete waste of your time and money. Okay, think about it. You want so much in the whole day, and firstly, we're all so stressed out. We really do need a lot. Plus, all of our food is not organic. Even if it's organic, you don't know. So, a manufacturer has to make a tablet this big if he wants to give you 2000 mg of omega-3 and 2000 mg of vitamin C and all of that. So, the best thing to do is take Soul Vitamins. Soul Vitamins means just one or two capsules of omega-3, depending on the dosage, or one capsule of vitamin C. Now, the basics would be B-complex. Everyone needs B-complex. Take that. Unless you have high blood pressure, be careful. The other thing, second thing is omega-3, yeah? All of us need it. Because we have too much omega-6. So to improve the balance, everyone needs an omega-3 tablet. Which one? Anyone, as long as you have about 1000 mg a day, that's basic. Huh? So don't do multivitamins at all.
Calcium,
you need at least 2000 mg, between 1000 and 2000 based on what your age is.
It's safe to take the calcium.
Eat three, yeah, of course. But calcium, now just remember, nothing will go to your bones, only 25% will go if you are low in vitamin D. And most of us these days are low in vitamin D. So first check your vitamin D levels, bring that up to normal, and then whatever calcium you take in will at least reach your bones.
Any more questions?
Yes.
And if you have a good diet which is high in calcium, you won't need the calcium substitute.
Does B complex increase your appetite?
No, that's the biggest myth.
No, right?
No. But I tell you, B complex sometimes doesn't work for a lot of people. Not a lot,
So it helps to curb the appetite also? There's nothing.
Some people feel it.
If it does any of these two, please call us and tell us.
No, there are some people on the internet that it helps you curb your appetite.
It doesn't do anything to your appetite, to be honest. Just keeps your metabolism really healthy. You should take it in the morning with your breakfast.
Whey protein, what we say after the workout. Some say it's artificial.
It depends, again, I know I'm sounding repetitive, but honestly it depends on your fitness goal. If you're already eating enough protein, then why take the protein shake? Yes, it's true, if you've done any resistance training, you will be low on protein after your, not low on protein, but your muscles are going
to
be...
But I'd like to say that if you take a scoop of whey protein, that's about 25 grams of protein, which your body cannot digest at one time. So, whey protein, 25 grams, definitely not. It's easier if you're a non-vegetarian, eat eggs. You know, it'll be slow. And none of us are lifting. If you're vegetarian, you have tofu, you have paneer, you can have... There are healthier whey proteins now in the market, which is pea protein, which is a purer form of protein. No, you get it on Amazon.in. Just type pea protein, you get brown rice protein. You get hemp protein, all of this, you get hemp here. And pea is the best. And then take the amount of protein that you need in a meal. That is the amount of protein that you need to consume. And this is pure protein. So it doesn't even take that much time to digest. So at one time, Rashi, this is my question to you. What is a good amount of protein that you can take at one time?
There's a lot of research that shows it should be below 25 grams. And above 25, your body can't really digest. But unless you've gone for a crazy workout, you've lifted a lot, then maybe a little more.
If you've done like a Arnold Schwarzenegger or a Salman Khan kind of workout.
Which
none of us
do. Exactly.
One other tiny thing, I just want to say, because everyone...
We all get the munchies around 5:30. I think that's the toughest time for everybody. That 5:30 chai, coffee, or iske saath kya. That's when all those cheese toasts and all those bhels and all those soya chaklis that you think are healthy, that's when all of those things come out. So 5:30 munchies, what can you suggest that's healthy for people? You know, just easy and, you know, healthy
and available.
Well, I would, you can add, but what I would do is, now this meal has to be a combination of carb, protein and fat, because that will keep you full. So I would take an avocado, add smashed dates in it, add raw cacao in it, maybe throw some walnuts and mix it up.
Rashi, these women are not going to do that. Give us something that they will have. Yeah,
okay,
we're just not going to do that.
I'll tell you what, take a bowl, make these little jars. If you're on the go, take a little bit of muesli, add some nuts in it and keep that with you so you can have that. Or you make energy bites. Take some smashed dates, put raw cacao in it, put sesame seeds in it, make these little balls and carry them with you. But
something that's grab and go. Something that's grab and go. Like, I know, like, she has the, yeah, so she has, like, the protein bake shop. So she does these really cool truffles that mom and I have every day at 5:30 with our chai.
These truffles are meant for fat. Like, they're meant for weight loss.
But I'm saying, you know, people want something that's yummy at that time, 5:30. Otherwise, you will eat that healthy thing and you will still go for the yummy thing. So you need something yummy that's healthy. So we do, like, roasted makhanas, which I think are fine.
You have to, for something like that, I think...
Makhanas
is great. You can use, and for something like that, you need to be prepared. So you keep it ready in your, you know, you stack it like how you buy cookies. So you take a little time and you make like a batch of roasted makhana with some nice masala and whatever you like, chaat masala, and keep it in your, you know, cupboard. So when you take that cup of tea, you go and fetch for that nice bowl of makhana, or you take, even if you take almond flour and you mix it with a little bit of cocoa and a little bit of honey, you can create really nice fudgy brownies which are there in your fridge. You just pick it out and eat a bite and you feel good about it. So it's so
But wait, listen. Sorry. But I swear to God, try this avocado mousse. It's really nice.
No, I believe you, but most people here are not used to even having that in their diet. And when you're at that 5:30, you just sort of have that yummy avocados in
you. You don't get good
avocados. We don't get good avocados.
I know, I've heard that. Sophie gets really good ones.
Sophie buys the imported avocados which we cannot afford.
No,
I don't want to invest 800 rupees in one avocado.
What?
Yes. So please,
they'll come and spend on us to make them lose weight. Yeah. They may as well buy the
avocado. I don't want to spend 800 rupees on avocado.
Try the brownie recipe in the book. It is with sweet potato and it has.
I like that.
Perfect. Yeah. It's
you Dubai nice. Person, please don't come to Mumbai and tell us you have supply avocados to us.
Try it, man. You have to try it.
Avocados are acquired taste. Not everybody likes.
The first time I hated it. That's what I was saying. The first time I hated it. But now.
Okay, so basically the point is, like, what can I just grab and go?
Okay,
just something that's ready.
I don't want to do
nuts
anything.
Nuts and dates. Nuts and dates.
A handful of walnuts.
Obviously, now these are common food. You guys already know, right? Don't you already know? But don't pick out biscuit. Biscuit is not food.
Why
use olive oil when you can use ghee? Also, Indian cooking, we cook at such high temperatures. Even tea is cooking for the longest time, you know. So then you should use oils which have a high smoking point, which is either coconut, mustard.
Coconut oil is a great smoke.
You will never know you're using coconut oil. The first few times you will feel little.
Yeah, it's not like, you know, you won't be
concentrated. And you won't look weak if you have ghee in your cooking, and the glow from your face won't go.
What's the brand? If Nature's Basket Oil, you get cold breast milk.
They're all available at Nature's Basket.
Yes.
Coconut oil and
everything is
conscious
food.
Also,
you're going for a Zumba class. Right. You know what? As soon as we're done with this, I'll talk to you personally because this is a very personal question.
Can I have the sweet potato brownie
instead
of biscuits?
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can. Not you can.
And you shouldn't even think of biscuits because there are so many other options.
I know, but I'm so
Over the years, Priyanka, you've taken so many things from me. How come you've not taken biscuits?
She comes with
biscuits.
Why
is
she not doing biscuits? Why do you have a biscuit?
I did try it in between, but I don't know somehow. You know,
that dark chocolate is an acquired taste. Think of the body you want and the bite you take.
That's why I gave up the morning tea and biscuits.
Okay, now after today I'm taking away your evening biscuits by the potato brownie. And when you make extra, I want to taste also. I told you I hate cooking, so anyone who makes this, please send me a batch.
Somebody can do tea and biscuits over. Biscuits
Okay, so thank you guys so much. You've been absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much, Sophie, for gracing.